Hello, I'm Tom, and welcome to Yah Wings, a channel where we discuss all things mystical and mysterious. And today, we're going to take a look at a poem, possibly written in the first century, titled The Hymn of the Pearl.
You remember the story I used to tell you when you were a boy? About a young prince sent by his father, the king of the east, west into Egypt, to find a pearl.
The Hymn of the Pearl is an ancient narrative poem told in the first person. It's about this young prince, the prince of the kingdom of the east. And it's said that as a boy, he dwelled in the palace of his father, and he delighted in the treasures and glory that his parents bestowed upon him. And he also delighted in his teachers, those who raised him. One day, when the boy was playing in the palace, his parents came to him and they presented him with a mission. They said, "Son, we need you to go down into Egypt, into the dark land, and there you will find a sea. At the bottom of the sea lies the one pearl. But be warned, the pearl is guarded by a fearsome serpent. If you can face your fears and dive down and retrieve the pearl, you will receive the robe of glory, and you can rule the kingdom on high with your brother, our second in command." The boy accepts the mission, and he leaves the palace with two escorts, but they can only go with him so far, and eventually, he's on his own. After a long journey, the boy finds himself in Egypt. Egypt is filled with all sorts of strange sights and sounds, but the boy ignores them and goes straight to the sea. There he finds the serpent, and the serpent's waiting for him and guarding the pearl. And he gets this idea. He says, "You know, this is really going to be hard. Maybe I should just wait until the snake falls asleep. Then I can just take the pearl from him. After all, there's an inn right over there that I can stay at." So as not to arouse suspicion, the boy brings a disguise, clothing he thinks is typical for the region. They all see through his disguise, so he loses it and enters the inn. There he meets all sorts of strange and wonderful people. He even meets someone from his hometown, the Kingdom of the East. And this traveler offers him a warning. "Don't get mixed up with these people." The boy thanks him, and when the traveler leaves, the boy immediately gets mixed up with the people of the inn. They give him their robes to wear, their wine to drink, and their food to eat. The food and wine make the boy very sleepy, so he checks into a room and goes to sleep. But there's a problem. Even though he's inside the inn, he is sleeping too close to the serpent.
"You can sleep safe and sound, knowing I am around."
When the boy comes to, he doesn't know where he is or how much time has passed. In fact, he doesn't even know who he is. Meanwhile, in the Kingdom of the East, the king is growing very concerned for his son. The king holds a high council, and they decide to draft a letter to send to the boy. They write the letter, and the letter magically turns into an eagle. The eagle flies from the palace and makes its way all the way down to Egypt to find the boy.
"You have forgotten who you are, and so forgotten me. You are more than what you have become. Remember who you are. You are my son, and the one true king. Remember who you are."
Having heard the words of his father, the boy remembers. He remembers who he is and the one who sent him. He dives to the bottom of the sea and enters the serpent's lair. It's said that he speaks the name of his father and mother and brother over the serpent, subduing it. He then retrieves the one true pearl from its resting place at the bottom of the sea, and he returns to his father's palace in the east. The king sees his son coming and runs from the palace to greet him. He runs out and embraces the boy. Then the young prince is wrapped in the robe of glory, the robe of truth. Having gone down to Egypt and retrieved the pearl, the boy reigns on high with his brother, the second in command. That is basically the Hymn of the Pearl. In the first part of this series, we talked about the father of analytical psychology, Carl Jung, and how he was very interested and deeply influenced by Gnostic texts such as these, written by early Christians. They were so important to his studies that the Jung Foundation would actually purchase Gnostic texts on the black market and smuggle them out of Nag Hammadi, Egypt. But what does this poem have to do with the field of analytical psychology? Enter Dr. Edward Edinger, the 20th century's leading Jungian analyst. In his book, Ego and Archetype, Edinger explains the Hymn of the Pearl. He says that this charming tale is a beautiful symbolic expression of the theory of analytical psychology concerning the origin and development of the conscious ego. The ego begins as a child of a royal heavenly family. This corresponds to its original state of identity with the self, or archetypal psyche. It is sent away from this original paradise on a mission. This refers to the necessary process of conscious development, which separates the ego from its unconscious matrix. When it reaches the foreign country, it forgets its mission and falls asleep. This situation corresponds to the ego self alienation and the state of meaninglessness. The letter from his parents awakens the sleeper and reminds him of his mission. Meaning has returned to his life. The connecting link between the ego and its suprapersonal origins has been reestablished. Now, if you're still awake at this point, you can see why the Gnostics preferred to use poetry to teach this. If, like me, you prefer spiritual terms, who better to interpret this than Harvard psychology professor turned spiritual guru, Ram Dass?
And if you see it as the one exploring itself through us, through these multiplicity of forms that are all part of the one, and that it goes into the dream or the illusion or the... It gets entrapped in the separateness in order to awaken out of the separateness in order to see itself. And it's just a beautiful dance of this delicate form of the one at play. Mm-hmm. The whole thing lightens up a lot.
Yeah. He goes down to Egypt. Egypt is the code word for this planet. It's a dark planet. Then comes the famous scene in which he goes to an inn. It's where the prodigal son stayed. What happens in the inn? You sleep too close to the serpent. And you forget what you came here for. So your time in the inn can be 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. This could go on until death, and it does with many men and many women.
We are all manifestations of Buddha consciousness, only don't know it. And the Buddha, the word means the one who waked up, bodh, to wake, woke up to the fact that he was Buddha consciousness. And we are all to do that. To wake up to our Jesus within us. This is blasphemy in the normal way of thinking in Christianity, but it's the very essence of Gnosticism.